Okay, I've run some tests with the rank tracker, and these are the results I've got. What you should do is go to preferences, customer profile, and go each of the settings in here. You will see are repeated over here, okay? So you need to set up, these are the basic information about your website. If you have some alternative URLs, these are automatically considered in here and in here. So if you check these two, you don't need to do this. But I've done it just as an example so you could understand better. I click on suggest and I allow the rank tracker to find some keywords relevant for me. I prefer to search on Google Raw and Yahoo Raw, which are Google and Yahoo Romanian versions. This is useful if you do a lot of Yahoo searches. It allows you to pull more requests for Yahoo more easily. Okay, I can get some competition analysis from Google's AdWords Keywords Planner. In here, there's a trick. I use this software for quite a while, and I prefer, this is generally checked always, and I prefer this option, 100 results per page, 50 or 100 results to check, but 50 is generally enough. If you run Google and position lower than 50, that you're just not there. Nobody's going to look through 6 pages of Google results. Even if they do, it's 1%. It's completely irrelevant. I uncheck this option because to me, it's not so important if I'm on 8th position or 7 or 5 or 9th. To me, it's more important. I get an overall understanding. So if I'm 100 results per page, I'm position 8. If I don't refine it, that 8 will remain unsure. So for example, if you search 100 results per page, you will see that it's not 100% match between 10 results per page, which is the standard search, and 100 results per page. So you generally need to refine if you want exact results. But I prefer to just use 100 results per page and not refine because it's much faster. Otherwise, for 50 pages, I would have to refine it 5 times. Page 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it would take 5 times longer. I prefer not to do it. Okay. These are some data which I got from Google Analytics. This is a customer profile. I can save my reports on SEO PowerSuite Cloud or on Dropbox automatically. In here, it allows you to set up some settings for saving as a PDF or zip file on your computer. In here, it will match human behavior on a search engine. The problem with this is that, okay, you need to set it. I would suggest you set every setting in here. It will take much longer to do the checkup. So if you don't if you don't check all these options, you might run into some problems with Google. But if you do check it, it will take you a bit longer to search to get the results. In here, it's a very useful tool. If I had more than one website to check, I would certainly go and buy the proxy for Rank Tracker. So if you have 10 websites to check, it will take so long to check it, but if you use proxy rotation, it will be much faster. And it allows you, there are some services which allows you to do much faster checkings. In here, so if you do 10 searches quickly, Google will tell, okay, perhaps you are not human, and it will ask for a verification code. And in here, you tell the software to give you the CAPTCHA, the security code, for you to fill it in. You can schedule some automatic searches, so if you leave the software running, you can make it automatically run. Okay, and there are some personalization. How many tasks should be done in 1 second? At the same time. Okay, so this is my website compared to other website. I use just Yahoo, but the results for Google are is pretty much the same thing. This is how it looks like. which pages I'm ranking with, and the comparisons with the other websites. This is how the results look like, and I have some competition with Softpedia and other websites. And here you can see ranking evolution, how my website fare against the others. You have to do some separate checkings for keyword difficulties and pay-per-click analysis. I haven't done them. In here you can see a comparison on the strength of the domain. So I am 229. Compared to the others, I am lower than most of them. But these are powerful websites on the Romanian internet. So they are much visible than I am. I'm not surprised. But still, I fare decently. For a personal blog, it's okay. These are some characteristics. Actually, here I'm worse than this. I am just one website is lower than mine. This, when you check go to blogspot.com, it's automatically taken from Google server, so that's why it says USA. But it's not USA. The same for YouTube. If you go to YouTube, it will recognize the IP and so on. But they have some servers in Romania also, so it doesn't necessarily mean that it's actually in the US. How many pages are in there? And in Bing. And other information about the websites. Here you can get some reports, visibility by search engine, what position I rank other for keywords, how I fare against the competition. But remember, these are keywords which have been selected from my Google Analytics data, so it's natural that I have a good visibility in those keywords. They are specific terms, so it's not that I am... If you look at this, I am like the second after Softpedia. It's not true. Those websites are much better than I am. But for the specific keywords, it's okay. How does my website rank against other websites? I search keyword research. And the domain strength. I like the software. I think it's the cheapest solution if you have more than one website for checking rankings. You have to start it on your computer and you have to use it a lot, but it allows you to get a much better understanding of your keywords than software which is purely online. You can add a lot of competitors and it's very stable. I've been using it for a while. This is just a test account which I created today just to check my own website. But I've been using it a lot for my clients and so on. One or two websites. It's not. I don't have a lot of web properties, but I've been using it for a long time, and I'm satisfied to how the software works. For money, for performance, I think it's currently the best solution you can get, because it allows you to check for a lot of keywords, a lot of domains, a lot of competitors, and the price is much smaller than what you get for other tools which you get online. And there are some free tools, but there are much poorer quality of this one. So it's a tool I recommend you to use. If you do SEO, you might consider using this rather than a tool which is completely online. Cheers.